Let's move on. Panacea Biotech is the stock in focus. Let's pull up and see where the stock is right now. A bit of a booster for the company. This morning they announced a pretty decent order from the government for about 187 odd crores. Let's touch base with the management to understand the order details. Rajesh Jain, the joint MD at Panacea Biotech, joins us. Mr. Jain, great having you with us on Profit. Congratulations first on this achievement. Can you talk about the order that you bagged, the scope of this particular project, and the probability of more such orders coming your way, particularly from the government?
Yeah, thank you very much, first of all, for inviting me to your channel this morning. It's a great feeling of getting back on track in terms of polio vaccine and restarting the contribution in eradicating polio from India. And this particular order actually covers two products, the trivalent OPV and bivalent OPV. And this will be supplied in the period close to 295 million doses, which is equivalent to almost 167 crores, will be supplied from the month of December until January. And then another 100 million doses of bivalent oral polio vaccine in the month of February 2012. These supplies will largely cover their national immunization days and sub-national immunization days of Government of India. And then we will have 50 million doses of bivalent oral polio vaccine supplied sometime in May 2013. And I believe with this, government is fully prepared to make sure that adequate quantity of vaccine is available and each child in the country receives a polio vaccine, which is the whole goal. So I believe it's a good contribution by Panacea in polio eradication once again.
Right. Any such other opportunities that you're working on in terms of mass immunization, planning to collaborate with government agencies on the same? You mentioned one about the polio vaccination. Anything else which is on the cards?
You see, if you see our track record for the last 20, 25 years, Panacea Biotech has been working very closely with the Government of India, UN agencies to make sure that good quality and safe vaccines are made available. And in that, we have supplied more than 9 billion doses of oral polio vaccine. So it's a huge contribution that we have done, which means that, you know, all these agencies remain very closely networked to us in all their initiatives. And polio is such a disease that you really cannot predict how the disease will behave in the coming years, and therefore in emergency situations, Panacea Biotech has had a tremendous track record of supporting UN agencies as well as the Government of India in making sure that should their emergency need arise, we really come on to the occasion and make sure that the vaccine is made available. So we really do not believe that as of now, beyond this, they would need quantities in this financial year. But should there be any need, we are completely geared up to support them in terms of short-term supplies as well.
I want to also get your perspective on the new drug pricing policy which has been notified last week. Most experts believe that it definitely is a game changer, but from the consumer side, for the local pharmaceutical industry, for the Indian pharmaceutical industry, it's a mixed bag with perhaps negatives outweighing the positives. Let me get your side of the story. How do you see this policy affecting the entire pharma sector and also you included?
What I personally believe is that, first of all, it's a very important step in moving away from the traditional cost-based pricing, market-based pricing system. And I believe that the government has really moved forward and made sure that there is a balance that they strike between the need that the industry has, at the same time to make sure that people on the ground, the normal people, continue to receive competitive, good quality pharmaceuticals as part of their healthcare. So I believe it was a very good balance that the Government of India has struck by bringing in this policy. However, in terms of making sure that new innovative products continue to come, R&D also gets promoted, I think it is over a period of time that we will come to know the real impact of this is policy. However, I believe that this will definitely make sure one thing, that a common man definitely receive the product at competitive pricing, while encouraging the industry to make sure that they continue to make investments in innovation, which is very necessary to bring new products on the market. And at the same time, they should have sufficient funds to make sure that good quality medicines continue to be manufactured by them, and make sure that as the regulations are changing there is an equal emphasis on training internally on the employees of the company who assure that safe medicines are brought to the market. Your GMP standards continuously go up. So I believe that there is going to be a lot of investments that the industry will still be able to make sure that the GMP aspects, the affordability aspects, and the innovation aspect in terms of new products is a balance is struck around all these three domains.
Okay. All right, Mr. Jain. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. Congratulations on the order win. Great having you with us, as well as sharing your thoughts on the sector, on the new pharma policy, and also on the achievement in terms of the government order. We'll take a break now. We'll come back and bring our viewers up to speed with the management commentary at SAIL. We spoke to the management earlier in the day. We'll bring you this exclusive conversation.